You know, the world of football can be weird sometimes. As fans, all we see is the 90 minutes of football with a score that basically tells us who's the winner. But behind the scorelines are some of the wildest and more bizarre stories that football's ever seen. And one of the main sources of these bizarre stories are contracts. But not just the amount written on it, but the more inner details of the contracts, like clauses, often demanded by the players rather than the clubs. Which is quite weird, because when a player signs a new contract, you would think all they really care about is how much money they're getting paid. That being said, a contract is far more than just the salary and the length of the deal. It's full of all sorts of terms and conditions, from bonuses to image rights and everything in between. There's literally all kinds of agreements. Some that you can say, oh dude, of course, that makes perfect sense. And some others that really leaves you scratching your head. So in this video, I'm gonna take an idea that one of my subscribers gave me in the comment section of a previous video. I'm gonna talk about some of the most bizarre contract clauses and the story behind them. And believe me, I've kept the best one for the last. But the question is, what makes them put these ridiculous clauses in their contracts? Well, stick around to find out, because there's some bizarre ones ahead. So without further ado, let's jump into those. Right, so just the other day, I was looking at an article about the space travel of Jeff Bezos. And instantly I thought, Jeff and I have one thing in common, and sadly, it's not our bank account, but the fact that we're both fascinated by space travels. But do you know who else thought space travel was cool in 1999? Sunderland player Stefan Schwarz. When he signed for Sunderland in 1999, he also thought about signing up for one of the first commercial flights to space. Unfortunately for him, Sunderland didn't really share his eagerness for space travel. And in a way, who can really blame them? After all, who wants their player to take the risk of blasting off to the space when they needed him on the pitch? So Sunderland decided to add a space clause into his contract, meaning that the contract would be cancelled if he went into the space. And later on, it turned out that one of the advisors of Stefan Schwarz actually booked a seat on that same flight. So in a way, who can really blame Sunderland wanting to get things tightened up, you know, just in case. Remember, this was 1999, and space travel was still a scary concept back then. And now, more than two decades later, Sunderland probably looked back and wonder why they even bothered to do it in the first place. And speaking of flying, we're gonna go from space travel to not flying at all. I think based on that last sentence, some of you old school football fans can guess who's gonna come up next. Enter the non-flying Dutchman, Dennis Bergkamp. Dennis Bergkamp is probably one of the greatest players to have ever played in the Premier League. He could do anything with the ball without showing any sign of fear. But there's one thing that really terrified him, and it wasn't within the green fields of football. You see, Bergkamp was afraid of airplanes, or more precisely, flying in an airplane. Dennis Bergkamp had a real phobia of flying. So when he negotiated his contract with Arsenal, he added a clause to make sure that he wasn't required to travel on trips where the club needed to take an airplane. Instead, he chose to travel by train or other modes of ground transport to Arsenal's away games, which obviously meant that he missed many away games in Europe where the distance was simply just too far. And while we're still on the subject of Arsenal, you probably wonder why former Arsenal player Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain didn't play as much for Arsenal. And when he did, he normally came on after the 71st minute. Well, here's the reason why. Arsenal had to pay Southampton £10,000 whenever he played for 20 minutes or more. So I guess Arsene Wenger was quite economical, even down to his team selection. By the way, it's quite normal to have a clause for an appearance fee. However, a clause that's activated within a specific time frame is quite odd, to be honest. Now let me tell you one thing, I wasn't really convinced of how true this one is. A, because appearance clauses are common in contracts. And B, in the world of football, £10,000 isn't really a fortune. So I took extra measures to research about it, just to verify this one. So take that as you will. And if you thought these clauses are weird, I left the most bizarre two clauses for the end. And trust me, they're quite bizarre. My final two choices are gonna make the first three look like amateurs. But before we go on with the final two contract clauses, a lot of time goes into making these videos, so your like and comments really mean a lot to me, and it really helps out the YouTube algorithm as well, as this is a young channel. So let's talk about one of the more bizarre contract clauses, one that involves, brace your ears, are you ready? Sheep testicles. Yep, you heard it right. I told you this was gonna be bizarre. This is certainly one of the tastier contract clauses, as former Cardiff owner Sam Hammam made sure that he was gonna be seen as the boss right from the start. The former Cardiff owner was no stranger to weird antics, and he took no exception to their new signing, Spencer Pryor. According to the contract clause at the time, he had to eat a sheep's testicle before he was allowed to play for the first team. For reasons still unknown to humanity, he made the poor guy eat sheep testicles. And he actually ate it. That's quite a ballsy move, my friend, pun severely intended. It was probably just a test of character for the new signing. He refused to eat it raw, but to his credit, he showed some testicular fortitude by eating it cooked with lemon and parsley. Alright, I'll stop with the puns, but you probably get the point by now. And by the way, just to sum it all up, it turned out that the dish was actually a chicken all along, which was shaped, and I quote, differently. Yeah, I told you it was gonna be bizarre. And now, let's go to my number one pick of the bunch, which involves houses. And not one, not two, but more. But it's not the kind of houses that you think. When Giuseppe Reina signed for Arminia Bielefeld in 1996, he honestly thought he was the best negotiator in the world. Aside from his wages, he also demanded that a new house be built for him for each season that he stayed at the club. And he was quite surprised when the club accepted his terms with a smile. Perhaps he should have known that it was too easy, because guess what? The type or the size of the house was never mentioned. So the club built him a house of Lego for each season that he was there. I guess he wasn't exactly the best negotiator after all. So, what do you think about today's top 5 picks with their stories behind? I'm pretty sure there's been quite a few weird clauses that were left out. Is there a football story that you'd like me to cover in a video? Let me know in the comments section below, but be nice to each other. I'm Football Drawn, and I like to tell football stories with comic and drawings. If you enjoyed this video, check out the rest of the channel as well.